Hello students, today we are going to learn geometric progression. Okay, in previous video we have learned arithmetic progression. Okay, now we are going to learn geometric progression, then how to find nth term of GP, then nth term from end of GP, and selection of terms in GP and sum of n terms of GP. Okay. So first we will see what is mean by GP or geometric progression. So a sequence of non-zero numbers is called geometric progression if the ratio of term and the term preceding to it is always a constant quantity. Okay. In arithmetic progression, instead of ratio, here it is a common difference or difference. If difference between term and the term preceding to it is constant, then we say that sequence is an AP. But if the ratio of the term and term preceding to it is constant, then we can say that sequence is a GP. Okay. So for example, if I am taking like this way, 4, 12, 36, 108 and so on. So if I am taking ratio of term and term preceding to it, means here 12 divided by 4, so this ratio is 3, or 36 divided by 12, that is again 3, 108 divided by 36, that is also 3. Okay. So if ratio is constant, okay, then in that case we can say that this sequence is a GP. Okay. And that constant ratio we called as a common ratio of the GP. In arithmetic progression, we called that difference as a common difference. So here we have to call it as a common ratio. Okay. And this common ratio we denote as a small r. Okay. Now we will see how to find nth term of a GP. Okay. And before that, what is mean by geometric series? So if A1, A2, A3 up to A, this is a GP, then A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus so on AN, this representation is called as a geometric series, means sum of this, that is called as a geometric series. Okay. Now we will find nth term of GP. Okay. So here this constant ratio is called the common ratio of the GP, that is R. So A1 we have to consider as a A, that is the first term. In AP we have to consider first term as A. Similarly in GP we have to consider first term as A. Okay. Now here common ratio of the GP is R, so A2 by A1 is equal to R, or A3 by A2, that is equal to R. Okay. So by using this, now we have to find nth term of GP. So now we will see general term of GP. Okay. So if A1, A2, A3 and so on AN is a GP. Okay. So if this is GP, common ratio or ratio between term and term preceding to it is always constant. Okay. So here A1 we have to consider as a A, then A2 divided by A1, that is a R. Okay. So this is common ratio, we have to consider as a common ratio is a R. So A2 divided by A1 is R. So A2 we can write A1 into R, and A1 means A, so this is AR. Okay. Similarly A3 divided by A2, that that is R. So A3 is equal to A2 into R. Now value of A2 is A into R. So A into R, that is value of A2 into this R. So we will get AR square. Okay. So now we can write like this way, A into, here R is not there. So R raised to 1 minus 1. Here we can write R raised to 2 minus 1. Here we can write A R square. So R square we can write 3 minus 1 R raised to 3 minus 1. Okay. So A3 is equal to A into R raised to 3 minus 1. So if here it is 3, R raised to 3 minus 1. Here if it is 2, then here R raised to 2 minus 1. Okay. So similarly, if we generalize this, so we will get An is equal to A into R raised to, if here it is n, then R raised to n minus 1. Okay. So this is the general term or nth term of GP. Okay. In AP, nth term is A plus n minus 1 into D. In GP, nth term is A into R raised to n minus 1. Okay. So if we generalize this, we will get nth term is A into R raised to n minus 1. Okay. So terms we can write like this way. First term is A, second term is A into R, third term is AR square, fourth term is AR cube, and so on. And nth term is A into R raised to n minus 1. Okay. So general, if we write general terms of a GP, then we can write GP in this way. A, that is the first term, then AR square, AR cube, AR raised to n minus 1. Okay. Now we will see next point, that is a nth term from end of GP. Okay. So keep this formula in mind, that is A is equal to A into R raised to n minus 1. Okay. Now we will see next point. Okay, next point is nth term from the end of finite GP. Okay. So here, if you have to find nth term from end of GP, okay, so nth term from end of GP, and suppose GP consists m terms, okay, so here I am writing that first, that is if GP consists of m terms, okay, then nth term from end of GP, that is equal to m minus n plus 1th term from beginning of GP. Okay. So if you have to find nth term from end of GP, already we learned this, how we will get this m minus n plus 1 in AP. Okay. So nth term from end of GP, that is equal to m minus n plus 1th term from beginning of GP. Okay. So how we will write m minus n plus 1th term? Nth term An, that is A into R raised to n minus 1. Okay. So m minus n plus 1th term, that is equal to A into R raised to m minus n plus 1 minus 1. Okay. So because this is n, so n minus 1. So A into R raised to m minus n plus 1 minus 1. So we will get A into R raised to m minus n. Okay. So if we have to find nth term from end of GP, then that is equal to m minus n plus 1th term from beginning of GP. For this, if you have to use this formula, for this you have to find first how many terms are there in GP. Okay. So here I am considering there are m terms, total m terms are there. So if nth term from end of GP, that is equal to m minus n plus 1th term from beginning of GP. And we know that If we start from beginning, nth term we have formula a into r raised to n minus 1. So same formula I am using here, a into r raised to, then instead of n, m minus n plus 1 is there. So m minus n plus 1 minus 1. So we will get a into r raised to m minus n. So nth term from n of gp, formula is a into r raised to m minus n. So this is one formula. Another one is, if we reverse this GP, okay, means A1, A2 up to AN, this is a GP, we have to find nth term from end of GP. So I am reversing this GP, so first nth term is first, then n minus 1 term, and last term is A1. Okay, now if for this GP ratio is R, for if we write in reverse order, then this ratio is 1 by R. Okay, you can see this example. If here I am taking example, if suppose 2, 4, 8, 16 and so on, this is a GP. So for this GP, common ratio is 2, because 4 by 2 is 2, 8 by 4 is 2, 16 by 8 is 2. Okay, if I am writing this in reverse order, suppose I am taking 4 terms only, if I am taking this in reverse order, so 16, 8, 4, 2, okay, now ratio is 8 by 16, that is 1 by 2, or 4 by 2, 1 by 2. So here R is equal to 2, here we get R is equal to 1 by 2. So if we write GP in reverse order, then ratio becomes, here R is 2, here R is common ratio is 1 by 2. Okay, so similarly, if A1, A2 up to N is a GP with common ratio R, and if I am writing this GP in reverse order, we will get common ratio is 1 by R. Okay, now this common ratio is 1 by R. So if I am finding nth term from end of this GP, okay, that is equal to nth term from beginning of this GP, because I am writing this GP in reverse order. So nth term from n is equal to an, I am considering that is a L. Okay, so L into 1 by R raised to n minus 1, because here common ratio is 1 by R. Okay, so here nth term from n, we have another formula, L into 1 by R raised to n minus 1. Okay, so these formulas are important to solve example. Okay, so nth term from end of GP, A into R raised to n minus n, or we can use nth term from end of GP is equal to L into, L means last term, so L into 1 by R raised to n minus 1. Okay, so this is easy to, this formula is easy to solve example. Okay, so keep in mind this formulas, or here I am writing all this formula. First nth term from beginning, that is a into r raised to n minus 1, nth term from end of gp is equal to a into r raised to m minus n, if there are n terms, and nth term from n is equal to L into 1 by R raised to n minus 1. Okay, now we will solve example based on these formulas. First example is, find the ninth term and general term of the GP, 1 by 4 minus 1 by 2, 1 minus 2 and so on. Okay, so here first we have to write what is first term. So here A is equal to 1 by 4 and R is equal to, now here everywhere common ratio is, or ratio is constant, so here I am taking this minus 2 and 1, so minus 2 divided by 1, that is equal to minus 2, so R is equal to minus 2, or you can take this two terms also, so minus 1 by 2 divided by 1 by 4, you will get same answer, that is a minus 2. Now we have to find nth term and 9:30 only. Okay, so we know that an is equal to a into r raised to n minus 1. Okay, so we have to use this formula. A9 is equal to a into r raised to 9 minus 1, that is a into r raised to 8. So a is 1 by 4, r is minus 2 raised to 8. Okay, so now here minus 2 raised to 8, so that is a, if here it is even power, okay, even power of negative number, that we will get answer is positive. Okay, so minus 2 raised to 8, that is a 2 raised to 8 divided by 4. This 4 we can write 2 raised to 2. Okay, so if we simplify this, we will get 2 raised to 6, and 2 raised to 6 is 64. Okay, every time no need to find this answer, because sometimes numbers are big. Here it is easy to find, so I am writing this 64. Okay, otherwise you can keep as it is answer. Then an is equal to a into r raised to n minus 1. So a, here I am putting value, a is 1 by 4, r, that is a minus 2 raised to n minus 1. Okay, so answer is minus 2 raised to, or you can simplify this, minus 2 raised to n into minus 2 raised to minus 1 divided by 4. So this is minus 2 raised to n divided by minus 2 raised to minus 1. If I am taking in denominator, so it is 4 into minus 2, so that is a minus, this minus and I am giving here, so minus in bracket minus 2 raised to n divided by 8. So this is the nth term of the G. Okay, now we will solve next example. Second example is find the fourth term from end of GP. Okay, and GP is given 3, 6, 12, 24, and last term is given 3070. Okay, now we have this formula. Nth term from end of GP is L into 1 by r raised to n minus 1. We have to use this formula. Nth term from end of GP is equal to L into 1 by r raised to n minus 1. Okay, so before that, we have to find what is L, what is r. Okay, so L is equal to last term, that is 3072. R is equal to 6 divided by 3, that is a 2. Okay, now we have to find n is given 4. We have to find fourth term from end of GP is equal to L into 1 by r raised to 4 minus 1. Okay, so that is L into 1 by r raised to 3. Now put here values of L and r. L is 3072, 1 by r is 2 raised to 3. So that is 3072 upon 1 cube divided by 2 cube. 1 cube is 1, 2 cube is 8. If we divide this, 8 3s are 24, 6 remain 67. 8s are 64, 84s are 32. Okay, so fourth term from end of GP is 384. Okay, so this is fourth term from end of GP. Now we will take next example. Example is which term of the GP 2, 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 4 and so on is 1 divided by 128. Okay, so we have to find the n. Okay, so 1 by 128, that is a which place. Okay, so we have to find n. So we have to consider an is equal to 1 divided by 128. Then we have to find n here. A is equal to 2, r is equal to 1 divided by 2. Okay, now we have to use a into r raised to n minus 1. So an is equal to 1 divided by 128. So a into r raised to n minus 1 is equal to 1 divided by 128 a is equal to 2. So 2 into r is 1 by 2 raised to n minus 1 is equal to 1 divided by 128. So if we divide this 2 here, we will get 1 by 2 raised to n minus 1 is equal to 1 divided by 128 into 2. Okay. Now here 1 by 2 is there, so all the terms we have to consider in power of 2. So here 128 we have to write in power of 2. So 1 by 2 raised to n minus 1 is equal to 1 divided by 128. If we factorize this, then it is a 64, 32, 16, then 8, 4, 2, 2, 1. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And this 2 already there. So 1 by 2. This is, we can write 2 raised to 7 into this 2. So 1 by 2 raised to n minus 1 is equal to 1 upon 2 raised to 8. Okay. Then we can solve this one. If we take reciprocal of both sides, or we can write like this way, 1 by 2 raised to n minus 1 is equal to 1 upon 2 raised to 8. Okay, so if we write like this way, here base is same, we can compare the exponent. So n minus 1 is equal to 8, therefore n is equal to 9. Okay, so ninth term of this GP is 1 divided by 128. Okay, understand this one. Now we will solve next example. Next example is the 4th, 7th and the last term of GP are 10, 80 and 2560 respectively. Find the first term and the number of terms in GP. Okay. So here we don't know what is the first term, what is the common ratio. So by using this, we have to find first term and first term and number of terms in GP. Okay. So here what is given? A 4 is equal to 10. A 7 is equal to 80. Okay. So A 4 means A into R raised to 4 minus 1, that is equal to 10. That is AR cube is equal to 10. Here same A into R raised to 7 minus 1 is equal to 80. That is AR raised to 6 is equal to 80. Okay. Now in AP we have to solve 2 linear equations. Okay. So for that we have to add or subtract that 2 equations. Here we have to divide 2 equations. Okay. So I am dividing this. Okay. Here I am dividing this. AR raised to 6 divided by AR raised to 3 is equal to 80 by 10. So this A will get cancelled. R raised to 6 upon R raised to 3, we will get R raised to 3, and 80 by 10 is 8. So R raised to 3 is equal to 8. So we will get R is equal to 2. Okay, if we take cube root on both sides, we will get R is equal to 2. Now we have to put R is equal to 2 here. Okay, so A R cube is equal to 10. So A into 2 cube is equal to 10. So A 2 cube is 8. So 8A is equal to 10. A is equal to 10 by 8. That is, if you simplify this, it is a 5 by 4. Okay, so A, now we have A R. And we have last term is 2560. That is the nth term if we consider. An is equal to 2560, that is A into R raised to n minus 1 is equal to 2560. Okay, so here if we put value of A and R, we will get value of n. Okay, so here A is 5 by 4 into R is 2, so 2 raised to n minus 1 is equal to 2560. Okay, if you simplify this, 2 raised to n minus 1 is equal to 2560 into 4 divided by 5. So 5 5 is 25. 5 and 5, then 1 remaining, 5 to the and into 4, 4 to the 8, or we can simplify this 5 and 2. If we find factorization of 5 and 2, it is or we can write 5 and 2. We know that 5 and 2 is 8 cube, so this is 8 cube into 4, 4 is 2 square. Okay, now here 2 is there, so we have to write all the terms in power of 2. Now 8 is again 2 raised to 3, so 2 raised to 3 raised to 3, that is 2 raised to 9 into 2 raised to 2, so we will get 2 raised to 11. So 2 raised to n minus 1 is equal to 2 raised to 11. So n minus 1 is equal to 11, n is equal to 12. Okay, so 12th term is 2560 means, and 2560 is the last term. Okay, and that is the 12th term. So number of terms in GP is 12, and first term is 5 by 4. Okay, now we will take next point, that is a selection of terms in GP. Okay, next point is selection of terms in GP. Okay, so in AP we learn that how to select terms. If 3 terms are there in AP, we have to select A minus D, A plus D. So similarly here we have to select number of terms. Suppose 3 terms are there, then we have to select terms, that is A, AR, and here A by R. Okay, because here R is a common ratio, so terms are A by R, A, AR. Okay, and common ratio, that is R. Okay, if suppose 4 terms are there, then we have to select terms like this way, A by R cube, A by R, then AR and AR cube. Okay, so we have to select terms like this way, A by R cube, A by R, AR and AR cube. Okay, and in this case common ratio is R square. Okay, so if 3 terms are there, odd number of terms are there, common ratio is R. Terms are like this way, A by R, A, AR. Okay, if 4 terms are there, terms are A by R cube, A by R, AR, AR cube, and common ratio is R square. If 5 terms are there, then terms are A, AR, AR square, and here A by R square, A by R. Okay, common ratio is R. Okay, so if 3 terms are there, terms are like this way. If 4 terms are there, terms are this, common ratio is R square. Okay, and if 5 terms are there, these are the terms and common ratio is R. Okay, understand this. Now we have to solve example based on this. Example is, if the sum of 3 numbers in GP is 38 and their product is 1728, find them. Okay, so here 3 numbers are in GP given, so let A by R, A and AR are 3 numbers in GP. Okay, now these 3 numbers are in GP and their product is given 1728. Okay, first I am taking product, because if I am taking product, this R and this R will get cancelled and we will get value of A directly. Okay, so A by R multiplied by A multiplied by AR is equal to 1728. So if this will get cancelled, A cube is equal to 1728. If we find cube root, so 1728 is cube of 12. So if we find cube root, that is A is equal to 12. Okay, now A is equal to 12, we have to find the R. Okay, so what is given next condition, that is sum of 3 numbers is 38. So A by R plus A plus AR is equal to 38. If we take a common 1 by r plus 1 plus r is equal to 38. If we make same denominator, so 1 plus r square divided by r is equal to 38. Okay, now value of a is 12, so 12 into 1 plus r square upon r is equal to 38. Okay, now if we divide it by 2 to both sides, so we will get 6 into 1 plus r square is equal to this r, we have to multiply here, so this is 38, sorry, we have to divide it by 2, so here 19 r. Okay, now if we simplify this, 6 plus 6 r plus 6 r square is equal to 38 r. Okay, so 6 r square, 6 r minus 38 r, that is 32 r, and plus this 6 is equal to 0. Okay, now we have to find the value of r. Okay, so 6 are 36, so 9. Okay, 6 are 36. Now we have to find the value of, we have to factorize this 36. So 36 factors are, it is correct, no? Sorry, 19 r it is. I'm taking 38, sorry. 19 r, so 19 r minus this is, we will get 13 r. Okay, so 6 are 36, 9 4s, so 6 r square minus 9 r minus 4 r plus 6 is equal to 0. So if we take 3 common, 3 r take common, so 2 r minus 3, here if we take minus 2 common, 2 r minus 3 is equal to 0, so 2 r minus 3 and 3 r minus 2 is equal to 0, so we will get value of r is 3 by 2 or r is equal to 2 by 3. Okay, now if we take r 3 by 2 and a 12, and if we put here, we will get 3 terms. Okay, so here I am writing this, a is equal to 12, r is equal to 3 by 2. So a by r, that is 12 divided by 3 by 2, so 24 divided by 3, that is 8. Okay, so a by r is 8, second term a is equal to 12, and third term ar, that is 8 into, sorry, 12 into 3 by 2, so 2 6 3 is 18. Okay, so terms are 8, 12 and 18. Okay, if we take a is 12 and r is equal to 2 by 3, we will get same numbers, that is 8, 12 and 18, but in reverse order. Means first we will get 18, then 12 and then 18. Okay, so 3 numbers are 8, 12 and 18. Okay, now we will take second example. Example is, if the continuous product of 3 numbers in GP is 216 and the sum of their products in pairs is 156, find the numbers. Okay, so here 3 numbers are given in GP, so write the 3 numbers R, A by R, AR in GP. Okay, then first product of 3 numbers is given 216, so A by R into A into AR is equal to 216, so this will get cancelled, A cube is equal to 216, so A is equal to 6. Okay, now A is equal to 6. After that, what is given? Sum of their product in pairs, means if I am taking AR into A plus A into AR, plus a by r into ar is equal to 156. Okay, so a by r into a plus a into ar plus a by r into ar is equal to 156. Okay, so we can take a square common. What is remain? 1 by r plus r plus 1 is equal to 156. Okay, now a square value of a is 6, so 6 square is equal to 36, sorry, 6 square into, if you make same denominator, so 1 plus r square plus r divided by r is equal to 156. Okay, so here we can divide this 36 here, so 1 plus r square upon r is equal to 156 by 36. So 6 6 are 6, 3 are 12, 15 minus 12, 3, 36, 6 6 are, okay, 6 3 are, sorry, 6 2 are, 6 2 are 12, 15 minus 12, 3, 36, 6 6 are, okay, again 2 3 are and 13 are, okay. So here, so we will get here this 3 multiply here, so 3 plus 3r plus 3r square is equal to 13r. So we will get equation 3r square, 3r minus 13r, that is minus 10r plus 3. So 3 3 is 9, we will get factors are 9 and 1. So here 3r square minus 9r minus r plus 3. So 3r be common, r minus 3, minus 1 common, r minus 3. So r minus 3 and 3r minus 1 is equal to 0. So r is equal to 3 or r is equal to 1 by 3. Okay. So we will get value of r is 3 or 1, r is equal to 1 by 3. So if we will take a is equal to 6 and r is equal to 3, a by r, that is 6 by 3 is equal to 2. So this is first term, a is equal to 6, this is second term, and ar is equal to 6 into 3, that is 18. Okay, so 2, 6 and 18, these are the three terms. Okay, if I am taking a is 6 and r is equal to 1 by 3, we will get same terms but in reverse order. So terms are 2, 6 and 18. Okay, now we will take next example. Third example is find three numbers in GP whose sum is 13 and the sum of whose squares is 91. Okay, so three numbers are a by r, ar in GP. Okay, now what is given? Sum is 13, so a by r plus a plus ar is equal to 13. So if you simplify this, if you take a common, 1 by r plus 1 plus r is equal to 13. That is, if you make same denominator, so a into 1 plus r square divided by r is equal to 13. Okay, or we can write a by r into this 1 plus r square is equal to 13, or a into this 1 plus r square is equal to 13r. Okay, now next is given, that is a sum of whose squares is 91. So a by r square plus a square plus a square into r square is equal to 91. Okay, so if I am taking a square common, what is remain? 1 by r square plus 1 plus r square is equal to 91. That is a square, If we make same denominator 1 plus r square plus r raised to 4 divided by r square is equal to 91. That is a square by r square is equal to 1 plus r square plus r raised to 4 is equal to 91. Okay. Or we can write a square into 1 plus r square plus r raised to 4 is equal to 91 r square. Okay. Now if we take this term, okay, or this equation, and if we take square of it, okay, so we have this equation. Suppose this is equation 1. So a into 1 plus r square is equal to 13r. Okay. Now if you make square of this, so a square into 1 plus r square bracket square is equal to 13 square is 169 r square. Okay. Now if you make square, that is a square as it is, 1 plus r square bracket square, that is a plus b plus c bracket square. So 1 square as it is plus r square square, that is r raised to 4, a plus b plus c bracket square, that is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. So 2ab, that is 2 into 1 into r, that is 2r, 2 into r square, that is 2r square, sorry, 2r cube, and 2 into 1 into r square, that is a 2r square, okay, is equal to 169 r square. So a square 1 plus r square plus r raised to 4 plus, if we take 2r common, 1 plus r square plus r is equal to 169 r square. Okay. Now if you multiply this a square to this term and a square to this term, so we have a square into 1 plus r square plus r raised to 4 plus 2 a square into r, 1 plus r square plus r is equal to 169 r square. Okay. Now a square into this, we have value a square into 1 plus r raised to 4, that is a 91 r square, plus this a into 1 plus r square. So this we can write 2 a r, and 1 a we have to multiply with this, 1 plus r square plus r is equal to 169 r square. Okay. Now I am rubbing this. I want this first equation. Okay, here a 1 plus r. Okay. Now this is 91 r square plus 2 a r, and a into 1 plus r square plus r we have, it is a 13r. So this is into 13r is equal to 169 r square. Okay. Now 91 r square, if we subtract from this, so here we will get 26 a r square is equal to 169 r square minus 91 r square. So 169 minus 91, that is 9 minus 1, 8, 16 minus 7, so 78 r square. So this r square will get cancelled. 26 a is equal to 78, so a is equal to 3. Okay. So we will get b is equal to 3. If we put a is equal to 3 in first equation, that is first equation is a by r, that is a into 1 plus r, sorry, a in bracket 1 by r plus 1 plus r is equal to 13. Okay, sum of the terms is 13. Okay, so if we put a is here, and if we simplify this, we will get value of r. Okay, now I am having this one. So A into value of A is 3. So 3 into, if you make same denominator, 1 plus R square plus R, or R plus R square upon R is equal to 13. Okay. So 3 plus 3R square plus 3R is equal to 13R. So 3R square minus 10R plus 3. Okay. So if you simplify this, 3R square minus 3R, sorry, minus 9R minus R plus 3 is equal to 0. So if we take 3 common, 3R common, R minus 3, minus 1 common, R minus 3 is equal to 0. So R minus 3 and 3R minus 1 is equal to 0. So we will get value of R is 3, or R is equal to 1 by 3. Okay. Now we have A is equal to 3 and R is equal to 3 or 1 by 3. So if I am taking A is equal to 3 and R is equal to 3, so terms are 3, that is first term is A by R, that is a 3 by 3 is equal to 1, then A, that is 3, then AR, that is a 3 into 3, that is a 9. So terms are 1, 3, 9. Okay, if we will take R 1 by 3 and A 3, we will get terms are same but in reverse order. Okay, now we will take next point in next video, that is sum of n terms of G. Okay.